first off, weather aside, what's it like being at the London Film Festival?
You know what? It's great. I've been here a few times, and it's always like a cliche, raining whenever I turn up. But I do love it. I don't go to many festivals, so I don't have a much of a frame of reference for. Sundance is nice because they've got ski slopes, but here's nice, especially for a sort of homegrown film. And I'm really proud of the movie, and so it's nice that it's having its premiere here rather than somewhere it doesn't belong.
Well, speaking of the movie, for fans who are looking forward to seeing Blood, can you tell us a little bit about your character and what attracted you to the role?
I play a man called Joe Fairburn, and he's a detective, and he probably shouldn't be, and he is dedicated to try and keep crime and the community separate, and he does something in a moment of rage that is so heinous that he can't undo it, and he unravels because of it.
It's a fantastic cast as well, especially British talent. What's it like acting opposite someone like Stephen Graham?
Stephen Graham's a little bit like what I imagine it feels like to be close to lightning striking.
Okay, in what sense?
You just feel the hair on your hands and your back of your neck start standing up, and it just feels dangerous in a way that you're not, that often isn't the case, and it's wonderful.
Fantastic director as well. How was it working with Nick?
I adore Nick, and I will work with him as often as he will let me.
We loved hearing you as Jarvis, of course, in the Iron Man series. How's filming going on the third movie?
I don't know. I have nothing to do with it until they're finished, and then they call me up and I turn up and I talk for 2 hours, and then they give me a bag of cash, and I go home feeling guilty, weirdly, that I've got a bag of cash, because it doesn't feel like work.
Sounds wonderful. And in one sentence, why should fans go and see Blood?
Because it's a movie that sort of harkens back to great American movies of the 70s, like Sidney Lumet movies. I think it's a thriller, but it's a really fulfilling, emotional thriller.
It's great, you know. I think it's a fantastic thing, the London Film Festival. There's been a few films now that I've been involved in here, and I just think it's a great thing, you know, for us to have a place where we can showcase the stuff that we do, you know what I mean? And such great talent as well. It's not just about the bigger films, it's the smaller little tiny independent films and the short film categories as well. They do some great stuff.
What do you think it does for a movie having it shown at this festival?
I think it's great, and you know, obviously we get to meet huge lot and get to try and sell the movie a little bit, but it's just great for us to have this. You know what I mean? It's really important, and we should never lose it, because we should never put our money into the likes of Dancing on Ice and all that kind of nonsense. You know what I mean? Celebrity Come Down With Me and all that shit. So it's great to have something where we can actually, you know, show what we're doing over here.
You mentioned incredible talent as well, unbelievable cast in this film. What's it like working with everyone?
Paul was amazing to work with. You know, we're very close friends, so the relationship was already there. But we moved in together while we were shooting, just because there was so much to do in such a short space of time. So we'd work on the scenes, you know, the night before, and then we'd go in and we'd be completely prepared and ready for Nick the next day. But it was a great experience, and I think it really, really helped a lot.
And for people,
and he did me washing as well.
That's vital, isn't it?
Exactly.
For people looking forward to seeing Blood, can you tell us a little bit about your character and what attracted you to the role?
I thought the script was fantastic. Do you know what I mean? It's such a dark piece, a really dark piece, and it's very. I mean, it's kind of like taking the law into your own hands slightly. Do you know what I mean? It's and that's what really interested me, because you know it's that kind of fine line of what's right and what's wrong, and how far do you go if someone's doing, you know, evil things to you, excuse me, to your children or something like that. It was a really interesting script, and the director Nick, I've worked with Nick before, and it was fantastic. It was a great script, actually.
We all know you're an incredibly busy man. Finally, what are you working on at the moment? Is there anything you can tell us about?
I've just finished Boardwalk, which is on now. I'm gonna have a little break at home with the wife and kids for a while, and then we go back next year to do season 4. And there's a few other things in the pipeline that I'm working on at the minute. I'm gonna set up my own production company. I'd like to make a film next year, not direct it, but I'd like to produce it.
It's a thriller. We're about two policemen who are brothers, and they're part of a police dynasty, really, and their father was a very overbearing himself, played by Brian Cox, an overbearing bully of a man, but who's himself a cop. And for very good reasons, these two cops, Joe and Chrissy, played by Paul Bettany and Stephen Graham, do something very bad, and they end up investigating their own crime. And it's the eddy currents of psychological collapse that swirl within them as the thriller unfolds that becomes the main body of it. Less about the police investigation and evidence bags and interviews, and more about how the hell they're going to cope, how the hell they're going to get through this. There's two dynamics. There's the thriller element as you watch your film unfold, and things just get worse and worse and worse. And that was one of the dynamics that Bill, the writer, wanted to go for, was things always get worse for them and tighter. The knot around their necks gets tighter and tighter. But what I wanted to take them away from them, what they're thinking about sitting on the bus, is, as I say, more of a Greek tragedy. You feel you've watched something that's bigger than just the thriller. It doesn't talk about its themes during the film. It doesn't unfold in this sort of, oh, look, here's this what it's about. This is deep, it's deep. In a way that perhaps, you know, very admirable art house films can discuss their theme as they go. I don't see this film as discussing a theme. I see this film as exposing a theme that you can take away and deal with afterwards. And those are themes that are very familiar to us, and very familiar to us, what I mean is family and loyalty and the pressures of family and the expectations of those around us that we respect.
And with such a fabulous cast as well, what do you think they brought to the movie?
Well, if you've got a cast this good, your cracker's not to listen to them. Okay, so I make sure, particularly when I've got actors I can trust like that, I make sure I give them enough freedom to investigate and interrogate the material during filming. When I film, it should really be more of a rehearsal. It should feel like a rehearsal rather than anything too set in stone. I've got a very firm idea about what I want, the look, the feel, the timing, the pacing, the thing. And in the absence of that, I'll be damn sure that everybody knows that that's where it's going. But I'd be also stupid not to keep my ears open. And keeping your ears open when those sort of actors are working, you gain incredible moments of surprise that just transcend anything I could have brought to it in a planned way. You know.
How exciting is it to be at the London Film Festival?
Oh, it's so exciting. I don't even care about the rain. I'm absolutely thrilled to be here. It's really exciting.
What do you think it does for a movie having it shown at this festival?
I just think it gives us a great platform. We've got brilliant actors in this country. We create brilliant films, and to actually have a festival that celebrates that, I think, is brilliant. And you know, not all films are going to be shown here. So there's so many films that are made that don't get shown here. So if you are lucky enough to have a film that you're in shown here, it does feel very special.
For fans looking forward to seeing Blood as well, can you tell us a little bit about your character and what attracted you to the role?
Yeah, I play Gemma Venn. She's a chef, and she's the long-term partner of Stephen Graham's character, Chrissy. She adores him. They've got a very sort of loving relationship, but she sort of stands slightly apart from him and his family, who are almost too fiercely loyal to one another. And within the story, this awful crime happens, and she watches her boyfriend change from this very happy-go-lucky, cheeky chappy to being eaten by this sort of terrible secret that he has. And it very much changes their relationship. And she, and when she finally discovers what's gone on, she actually has to decide whether she's going to stand by him or not.
It's an unbelievable cast as well. Great director. How was it on set for you?
It was brilliant. I mean, it was an intense script, an intense job, lots of very intense scenes. But actually, what's so great about the actors is that a lot of them, we had to kind of lighten the atmosphere a little bit between takes. So we'd have a bit of a laugh between takes and then get back to some sort of very serious emotional scenes as well.
Did you learn anything as well, working with such incredible talent like that?
Yeah, I mean, Stephen Graham particularly, I keep talking about him the whole time, but seriously, I think he's brilliant. He's incredibly naturalistic. When you're in a scene with him, you have to, you know, we did a lot of improvisation, and I really sort of just fed off of him, really, and he made it easy for me. It's very easy to raise your game when you're working with such brilliant actors.
And what are you working on at the moment? Have you got projects you can tell us about?
Yes, I've just finished filming a series called Mr. Selfridge, which is all about the very charismatic man who set up Selfridges and his sort of loves and disasters in his life.
Something a little bit more lighthearted then?
Well, sort of, to begin with, but actually it sort of goes down a little bit of a darker route at some points as well.
And just before we let you go, in one sentence, why should people go and see Blood?
you should see Blood for an edge of your seat suspense thriller that covers everything from love, family, anger, hate, rage, and life.
Should go on the poster.
Wow!